basically for me, it always comes back to people, right? So I want to understand people. I want to design for them in the best possible way. Design when developing a medical robot is so important because it's a very complex system, and in general, complex systems are a little bit harder to interact with. By understanding how people think and how they will interact with the product, I think is critically important. So, you know, we want to make sure that we create something that is very, very usable, but is also delightful. People think that, oh, it just needs to work, right? Yes, it needs to work. But the people that are working in the room, the surgeon, everybody needs to be in the best possible mindset for success, where they're comfortable, they're enjoying the product that they're working with, and that they support and elevate what they do. We want to create tools that allow them to be more successful, to better serve their patients, and to do so in a way that's repeatable, but also very flexible and adjustable. We don't just want to replicate what other people are doing. The end game is to change clinical practice. So my training originally was actually pretty technical. Got a master's in aerospace engineering. I thought I was gonna do, like, you know, satellites and Mars rovers, and later I actually got another master's in biomedical engineering because I was like, well, I really like this MedTech stuff, so let's do it. The kind of constant throughout has been a passion for healthcare, a passion for this space, because I believe we can really make a big difference. What motivates me to get up every day and come to work, the mission that we're trying to bring to life, changing healthcare with an amazing medical robotic platform and a digital ecosystem we're building around it. And the other part to that is just the people. Really something that, at least for me, it gets me out of bed, it keeps me motivated.